All right. Welcome back, everybody. Sports Chat 503. Thank you guys very much for watching. First time, long time. Either way, I appreciate it. Coming to you live from Portland, Oregon. We are trying to break things down. It is quarantine time, so it is official. You are doing some strange things to pass the time. Playing a lot more Uno with the family or getting into some strange parts of YouTube that you never even thought existed. For me, I've gone down memory lane a little bit with the Ducks. I've watched a lot of old film. I've watched a lot of Rich Brooks show highlights from the 80s and 90s. It has been a blast. So we're done with the draft. We kind of got through some stuff there. I got videos on both those. I got the Herbert video and then the other video if you guys are interested. But this video is specifically talking about the best of for running backs. I did a best of quarterback video. I've gone through pretty much everything that I... From my perspective, again, this is just my opinion, but I've done a lot of research on these things, gone through, and it's kind of a history lesson. I mean, that's a little bit of what I do naturally is to kind of teach some history. So whenever I can have an opportunity to be able to give some feedback to some younger Duck fans and kind of try to help people understand where the Ducks are at right now with the football program. So best of, not necessarily something that I'm really hyped about historically. I do not really think about these in terms of best of players, and it's kind of hard for me. Even when I get to the top five, I'm like, all these guys could be number one in my mind. So love the feedback. If you're interested, hit the comments, try to hit them back to you, and we'll talk about these things. Okay, let's go through these. The way I've done this is I have kind of an old timer section that I do not compare. It's kind of like 1970-ish is kind of the cutoff. Some guys made it from the early 70s, some guys didn't. Anything beyond that from the 60s or 50s or 40s, kind of go into that category. And then I kind of have my favorite that's not on the list. And then I have an honorable mention category. Then I got top 10. So I've tried to fix in as many guys as I can, okay? For the running backs, you got to go old school. You got to go Mel Renfro, okay? Pride of Portland, one of the best athletes to ever go through U of O. Very successful. A pro career, and just an all-around stud. I'm going to go through kick returners as well. There's going to be some running backs who are also on that kick return, punt return list as well, so you might have a little bit of carryover. My personal favorite is Latin Berry. From the local area, went to Milwaukee High School, absolute stud, could be one of the greatest athletes to ever attend the U of O. Was an absolute freak athlete. Great track guy. Pretty good football player. Came at a time where they were running IBAC stuff. He would have been amazing in today's game when they spread that out. Played with Derek Lavelle, also an amazing running back. So it's pretty interesting to kind of see where these guys fit into this thing. So those are my two early on. Honorable mention to me has got to be DeAnthony Thomas. I do not know where to put DeAnthony Thomas. I think he's one of the greatest athletes and players we've had at Oregon. He's top 10 somewhere, whether that's receiving, whether that's running the ball. His numbers are crazy. And I've got numbers on all these guys, but DeAnthony's numbers are ridiculous. Okay, DeAnthony has over 1,000 yards rushing, over 1,000 yards receiving, almost has 2,000 yards rushing. 243 attempts for 1,890 yards for rushing. He had 26 rushing touchdowns. He has 15 receiving touchdowns. So again, DeAnthony Thomas and Bobby Moore both are kind of in this strange category of they're good enough to possibly be on both lists, a running back and receivers list. They put up some seriously good numbers. So let's do top 10 here. 10, I got to go with LeGarrette Blount. LeGarrette does not have the numbers everybody else has because obviously we had the Boise State game and the fiasco that happened afterward. I'm a huge fan of LeGarrette Blount. This might be my own personal bias that he's on this list, but I tend to think he is a dominant running back. When he got there, his first year had 17 touchdowns in the first year. Was an amazing force, could really, really run the ball as well, not just the load and not just a short yardage back in that Oklahoma State game. Holiday Bowl hurdled the guy and ran another 20, 30 yards with guys climbing all over him into the end zone. One of the greatest plays I've seen, so big fan of LeGarrette Blount. Number nine is Ontario Smith. Ontario Smith is one of those guys who, very similar to Maurice Morris, I didn't really know where to put these guys, and I ended up not having Maurice Morris on the list. It kind of broke down to one of those two guys were going to be there for me, but I think Maurice could have been obviously in this list as well. But Ontario Smith's numbers are pretty crazy. Again, they had 26 touchdowns. He had 285 yards at Washington State. Pretty amazing running back. Went to the pros, obviously had some stuff going on in the pros. And a lot of times these guys just don't get the same success in the pros. LeGarrette had a great pro career, where Ontario Smith really did not have much of a pro career after the first year or so. Jeremiah Johnson, I have at number eight. I think this guy is one of the greatest all-around running backs we have at Oregon. He came at a time right when Chip came in, and the Chip numbers are really hard to compare with any other era. When you compare the offenses and the best offenses, which is another list that I did, the Chip numbers are ridiculous, and it's really difficult to compare them. So he was kind of the first that got to kind of reap the rewards, shall we say, of having that new offense, and his numbers are crazy. His record that he holds is 6.69 yards a rush in his career. So per rushes, this guy got it done. 30 touchdowns in his career as well. Just an amazing, amazing running back. Number seven, I got Saladin McCullough. I think McCullough is a very unique running back and would have done crazy things in the Chip Kelly offense. He was just a super, super gifted running back, a very smooth running back. Go watch the Air Force game, the 1997 Vegas Bowl. Go watch that one. There's some great highlights in there. But he's just such a smooth runner. Okay, six is one I think could be almost in the top three or two is Kenyon Barner. At number six, I think Kenyon, I was so blessed to be able to watch every home game he had, all the bowl games throughout his career. Kenyon Barner was an amazing, amazing player. The fact that he came at the same time as LaMichael James, he kind of got overshadowed a little bit, but I think Kenyon Barner was an incredible player, very unique player out of the backfield. His record is he has the most rushing yards in a game at USC, 321 yards at USC. Just an amazing running back. 48 touchdowns. 48 touchdowns. I mean, golly. So, again, when you compare and contrast, you know, he's got 3,600 yards. You know, you compare that to LeGarrette Blount, who has 1,000 yards. You know, so how do you put them on the same list when you talk about these numbers? Even though Garrett was in that Chip Kelly offense as well. But, you know, it's hard to compare. At number five, I got Reuben Drones. I think Reuben Drones, at a certain point in his career, between the injuries, could be the best running back Oregon ever put on the field. There was a time in Reuben Drones' career where I think he is in the conversation of being one of the greatest. Just an amazing player, played through injury, ankle, foot problems, had other injuries nagging him, but just an amazing player. Came at a very unique time in Oregon's history, right at the kind of the birth of the modern Oregon with the newer uniforms and the O and the new branding. Super important, important guy. At number four is Derek Lavelle. Derek Lavelle was the guy when I was a kid and was a record holder for a long, long time. Had a great career. They ran the ball a lot with him. They threw the ball to him as well out in the flat, but this was a time when they ran the I formation and Rich Brooks was running the ball. And with Derek Lavelle, he got a lot of touches. And so he has 814 touches, you know, so again, you know, hard to compare with that when you get that many touches. But even Derek Lavelle's numbers, you know, Kenyon Barner has more yardage, running the ball because of that Chip era, in less time, 45 touchdowns for Derek Lavelle. And, you know, again, historically he was always the one or two. And so you would have to kind of give him the respect of, in my mind, put him in the top five. Okay, top three. I think three is Royce Freeman. I know he's got crazy numbers and record and all that sort of stuff, but in my mind, impact runner that I've seen, when comparing this top three guys, I would have to put him at three. That's obviously no slight. This guy has pretty much every record in the book at this point. He's got the most carries with 947. He's got the most yardage at 5,600 yards, over 5,600 yards. He's got the touchdown record at 60. Okay, he's got 60 touchdowns. Okay, compare that to Ontario Smith, who had a great career, 26 touchdowns. He's got 60 touchdowns. Okay, the guy was an absolute freak. Big game for Royce, 246 versus Washington State. But Royce Freeman was an absolute load for a long time and got to play on some really, really good teams. Got to play on some teams that were just unreal and were just steamrolling people as well. So compare and contrast these top three. At number two, I got Jonathan Stewart. Jonathan Stewart came in as the number one recruit offensively that Oregon had seen in a decade. He was an absolute man-child coming out of high school, and was looked like pro body ready in college right off the jump. Ran kickoffs, was an amazing, amazing player. Fast and strong at the same time and big at the same time is a crazy combination. Had a great pro career, and, you know, it has to be recognized in the record books here. 1,700 all-purpose yards for Jonathan Stewart. Crazy, crazy stuff. Yeah, Jonathan Stewart is just an absolute beast, and I think he has to be put on that list for consideration because of just what he did in 1 year with some of his records, 1 year records, and also in his career. Just an absolute load. And I think that leaves us with number one. I think number one, there is some people who I think are going to agree with this, and I think there's other people who might, at this point, not, but it's got to be LaMichael James. LaMichael James is the best combination of speed and strength I've ever seen. He was the smaller back who was fast on the outside and breakaway speed, but he was never, ever, ever afraid to run through the middle. And he got tackled a lot. You know, at this time, Oregon was one of the number one offenses in the country, but they also led the country in, you know, a lost yardage play. So this guy gained a tremendous amount of yards. He also got stopped quite a bit too, based on how they ran their offense. They ran their offense in some seriously strange ways at that time, where they, you know, let linemen go and didn't block them. They went unaccounted, just ran away from them. And obviously it didn't work in the Auburn game when you try to go fourth down and run away from Nick Fairley. It doesn't work like that, right? But LaMichael James came at a very unique time. Obviously, Doak Walker, award winner, and the guy is just an absolute amazing player. 7.3 yards per rush is the record, and LaMichael just embodied, I think, at that point in time, what it meant to kind of carry the torch as a running back. That was a time when, you know, the running game was the whole driving force. And, in a way, as a history guy, talking about all this sort of history and going back in the record books, you know, Chip Kelly was an inventive coach, but he did a lot of things that were very old school. He did a lot of things that, you know, originated at the dawn of football. You know, we talk about the original Pop Warner teams and like Carlisle Indians and all this kind of original sort of stuff. Well, there were bits and pieces of those offenses that found their way into Chip's offense that you don't necessarily see in a lot of the pro style offenses. And I think when they were talking about how Chip wasn't going to be successful in the pros, it was because, you know, his offenses were actually somewhat basic. They were not as complicated and as people wanted to make it out to be. Now, he did have complicated plays involved, I'm sure, but there were a lot of times where Chip would go out there with, you know, a play sheet that was fairly small that had certain plays that he liked in certain places, and if it worked, it worked, and they just kept doing it. And a lot of it had options, obviously, with the zone, and I think LaMichael just benefited the most from that time with that offense and being that creative and literally giving the ball to them that many times. 771 rushes for LaMichael in his career. Okay, so again, we're in quarantine, so I'm going to do these videos. I've got a bunch of other ones. I've got wide receivers. I've got tight ends. I've got offensive line, defensive line. Go through the whole thing. And so I'll piece these out. I'll slowly put these out over the next week or two here and try to get some stuff talking about other stuff besides what they're talking about on the national level or anything else with the news. Again, tough times with coronavirus and for people, small business owners, everything else. My heart goes out to you guys. Hopefully we'll get this thing back rolling again. And hopefully we'll all be back in Autzen in the fall. All right, guys. Thanks for watching Sport Chat 503. Adios.